Okinawan Festival is proudly presented by the Hawaii United Okinawa Association, Central Pacific Bank Foundation, and these fine sponsors.
My name is David Jones, Okinawan Festival Chair. Welcome to Sharing Uchinanchu Aloha, the highlights of the 2021 Okinawan Festival this year. Once again, a virtual event on YouTube and Facebook and Okinawan Festival website.
Aloha, my name is Lin Miyahira, and I'm 2020 President of the Hawaii United Okinawa Association. 2021 has proven to be another year when we have to observe strict health restrictions to keep our community safe.
In the next hour, we'll share musical performances by some of our talented community musicians and entertainers. Tips on the best way to make everyone's favorite Oki Munchies, Undagi, and Underdog.
We'll get a glimpse into some of the exciting activities our HUOA members are engaged in, and take a look back at the history of the Okinawan Festival. We'll also get a sneak peek at some of the intriguing events planned for 2022.
But first, let's get moving. The performers of the Chinagu Eisa Hawaii show us how with their exciting Eisa drumming. This is a combination of dance, music, and various sized handheld drums that is sure to get your hearts pumping.
Here is Chinagu Eisa Hawaii with Isho Kemme.
Awesome job. Thank you to the members of the Chinagu Eisa Hawaii. Eisa is such a great way to connect the new generation with our rich culture and language. The Hawaii United Okinawa Association has 50 community clubs with thousands of members throughout the islands. We asked them what is their favorite place to visit in Okinawa.
My hometown of Nakagusuku Village is called the Hantamichi. The Hantamichi is a path that runs from Shuri through various castle sites across Okinawa.
My hometown of Yamitan Toguchi, where I played at beautiful sandy beach.
The aquarium, because I really like whale sharks.
Tsunomi, they have whale sharks.
Our family is from a small southern town called Gushicha. I've also heard it called Gushikami.
Orient Beer Factory.
And mine is visiting Naha, where my family is from.
Oahu Village.
Ojima, an island in Tamagusuku, where you have the best ika tempura in the world.
The Otoku Community Center. I got to meet relatives for the very first time, and even though there was a language barrier, we somehow communicated and still felt like family.
Murasaki Mura.
Shopping at Heiwadori.
To the Umi Aquarium to see the whale shark.
Do you have a special place in Okinawa that you enjoy going?
For me, it has to be Nishihara Town because that's where my relatives live. My father's side of the family is from a place in Nishihara called Gaza Yonogusuku. And so my favorite place has to be our hometown, my uncle's house in Nishihara. What about you, DJ?
Well, for me, family is very important as well, too. So my family is from Nahashuri area. And so whenever I go to Okinawa, I make sure to visit all my cousins, and my brother lives there as well, too. But aside from that, you know, wherever there is Okinawa soba and Orion beer, I'm actually pretty good.
It's true.
There are so many beautiful and fascinating sites to explore. One of those places is the centuries-old Shuri Castle. Pamela Young takes us back in time.
Towering over the capital city of Naha, Shuri Castle was the palace of the Ryukyu Kingdom since the 15th century. During World War II, it was almost completely destroyed in the Battle of Okinawa. After the war, the government repurposed the grounds as a university campus. In an ambitious restoration in the 90s, the site was reconstructed based on historical records and photographs. And shortly after, Shuri Castle was designated as a World Heritage Site. But in October of 2019, an electrical fire burned for 11 hours, leveling six of the main buildings. Reconstruction was delayed last year because of COVID and typhoons, but is slowly being resumed so that residents and visitors can once again see the majesty of the Ryukyu Kingdom.
Haisaigusiyo, especially to all you Uchina Jews and Uchina Jew in spirit. Bensore and welcome to our Okinawan Festival. My name is Pat Miyashiro, your HOA 2021 president. I must say it's been a challenge to figure out how we're planning to organize this year's festival after completing last year's successful event to keep up the traditions of our Okinawan culture. The HOA's mission is to promote, to preserve, and perpetuate our Okinawan culture through our performing arts group and provide a meaningful education through this venue. Putting on a festival is a daunting task, and we'd like to express our sincere appreciation to all of our sponsors who have generously donated their time and effort to our Okinawan Association. Thank you so much. We have been purchasing new equipment to enhance our broadcast for all of you. A great big mahalo to all the volunteers who have generously donated their time and effort to make this event a most memorable experience for all Uchina Jews and Uchina Jews at heart to enjoy. Thank you to all the Performing Arts Group for showcasing their Okinawan culture. It is just this spirit of Chimikukuru Tichi that continues to provide the energy for this experience. Thank you to all the club volunteers who have always answered the call when asked to help. Also, thank you for your continued support in purchasing our bentos and your donations to support our festival. You have supported our local Okinawan restaurants during this time, and they truly appreciate your patronage throughout the year. Please enjoy today's program. I hope you all brought your bentos to enjoy while watching the program. Thank you to all of you who are tuning in from around the world. Please let us know where you're viewing from. Again, Ippe Nihe Deburu, Mahalo, and Aloha.
Aloha and Hai Sai from Honolulu, Hawaii. My name is Paul Yonamine, and I'm the Executive Chairman of Central Pacific Bank. I'm incredibly proud of my Okinawan roots in Nakagusuku Village, and I'm pleased to see the Okinawan culture thriving here in Hawaii. CPB Foundation is proud to support community events such as the Okinawan Festival that showcase the beauty of Hawaii's multi-ethnic community. As you can see behind me, CPB has a long legacy of service to the people of Hawaii, and we are proud to serve the needs of all residents in our state. CPB has supported the Okinawan Festival with pride and gratitude for decades, from its early beginnings at McCoy Pavilion to Kapiolani Park and the Hawaii Convention Center. CPB has grown with the Okinawan Festival in service and scope. Besides the Okinawan Festival, CPB Foundation and the Hawaii United Okinawa Association have partnered on several events, such as the Family Noodle Pack distribution we did in partnership with Sun Noodle to help families during the COVID-19 pandemic. Before COVID-19, I was pleased to have been able to invite HUOA leaders to a presentation I did for top executives in Okinawa Prefecture. I was also fortunate to attend the HUOA's installation banquet in January 2020, one of the last large events held at the Hawaii Okinawa Center before COVID shut everything down. In 2020, I was excited to see the Okinawan Festival pivot to a virtual format so that our stories can be shared with a worldwide audience. And this year, HUOA has continued that approach to develop its online capabilities. As a bank that is putting particular emphasis on digital products and services, we appreciate the innovation. In closing, the CPB Foundation is proud to support the HUOA to ensure that it remains a leader in keeping our community connected. Although we can't be together for the second year in a row, I hope you are all staying safe while we continue to fight the COVID-19 pandemic. Mahalo and ipe nife debiru.
Tamagusukuryu, Senju Kai Hawaii, and all the talented dancers for your spirited performance. Our annual gathering could not grow to be Hawaii's largest cultural festival without the continued encouragement and participation of the community, especially our fabulous HUOA clubs whose members are devoted to keeping the traditional arts alive, like our Uchinanchu language.
Kahushi, which means heartfelt appreciation and gratitude for all that our ancestors did for us.
Nuchikusui, life medicine, nourishing her life with great food and wonderful friends and family.
Chibario, meaning do your best.
Chibario, which means go for it.
Chibario, and it means go for it.
Hakara, which means life is treasure.
This is how you introduce yourself in Uchinaguchi. Wane ashirulam yaibi, wane jusan yaibi, utashkuni gesabira.
The Okinawan proverb, Tusuya Takara, what means our elders are a treasure to us.
So Lynn, what is your favorite Uchinaguchi word?
My favorite Uchinaguchi word has to be yuimaru. We use it a lot in our organization, but I would translate it as communities helping one another. And so, you know, it has, I think maybe in Hawaiian, the closest word is laulima. And so I just like the way that that word encompasses what we try to do every day. What about you, DJ? What's your favorite Uchinaguchi word?
So, my favorite word is actually akisamiyo.
Akisamiyo.
So akisamiyo, because you know when I was growing up in Okinawa, my mom would always say akisamiyo. It means like, oh my goodness. And usually it was when I was doing something bad that my mom would say akisamiyo. So it's always stuck in my head.
Two people who are furthering the Uchinaguchi language are Brandon Uhugusku-ing and Yuki Shiroma. They have put Uchinaguchi language together with English to song and dance.
So I lived in Okinawa for almost 5 years total, and four of those years I spent teaching English at elementary schools in Naha City. And at that time is when I realized that, you know, most kids in Okinawa don't know anything about their own indigenous ancestral language. If you think about it, just a couple of generations ago, you know, I think most people probably were still speaking Uchinaguchi in Okinawa.
Because they were teaching Brandon's Let's Sing Uchinaguchi Lesson 1 song, I thought it would be a great opportunity to combine the dance and the music and the singing together.
Videotape in the lawn of the beautiful Okinawan Center here in Waipahu, right behind me.
One of the first things people notice when they come here is the statue of a distinguished gentleman with a faraway look in his eyes. Pamela Young explains more.
The statue that graces the Hawaii Okinawa Center shows a contemplative Kyuzo Toyama, the father of Okinawan emigration. Yet the many statues of him in Okinawa have him pointing east to the Pacific. Born in Back in Okinawa, Toyama became the principal of an elementary school who protested against inequalities within the Japanese education system. After reading the book Shokumin Ran, Theory of Colonization, he saw immigration as a way to emancipate Okinawans from Japanese authority. The next year, under his management, 30 Okinawans left Naha for Hawaii. A second group left 4 years later, including Toyama and his younger brother. After 6 months in Hawaii, he saw how seamlessly the emigrants assimilated. He returned to Okinawa and became an emigration agent, sending many of his countrymen to Hawaii and North and South America. Today, there are about 275,000 people of Okinawan ancestry living in other countries, thanks to Kyuzo Toyama pointing east.
Just because we're social distancing
doesn't mean we can't share aloha.
And our favorite Zippy comfort food.
Zippy's fundraiser just got better with more to choose from. Tickets can now be redeemed for breakfast and a drink, or even cornbread goes perfect with chili. Zippy's makes it easier to raise more money with more choices.
The Hawaii United Okinawa Association's Virtual Okinawan Festival is made possible thanks to donations from viewers like you. Mahalo and ippe nihe debiru.
There is so much more here at the Hawaii Okinawan Center for people to experience. HEOA Executive Director John Itomura and past President Lynn Miyakira lead us on a tour of the home of HEOA. Built at Gentry Waipio Business Park and more than 30 years ago as a tribute to our immigrant pioneers.
Aloha and haizai gusio. We're here at the Hawaii Okinawa Center to give you a very quick tour of our wonderful home of the Hawaii United Okinawa Association. My name is Lynn Miyahira, and I was a past president in 2020.
And I'm John Itomura, past president 2008, and we're glad you can join us for this wonderful tour.
So this building was built in 1990 with the help of many in our Hawaii Okinawa community.
And the purpose of this building is to give a tribute to our Iseis, and of course, probably many Niseis as well.
That's true. So we want to thank you for everyone who helped this make this dream a reality. So we're going to give you a quick tour today about the cultural and significant place of our beautiful home here in Waipio. I wanted to welcome you here to our Issei Garden here at the Hawaii Okinawa Center. It features a statue of Kyuzo Toyama, who is also known as the father of Okinawan immigration. He's from the town of Kin in Okinawa, and he worked very hard to make sure that Okinawans were able to find better lives around the world. And he sent the first group of Okinawan immigrants to Hawaii, who landed here in 1900. So this garden is dedicated to all of the Issei, all of the first generation immigrants who worked so hard to make better lives for the future generations here in Hawaii. I want to give a shout out to our Kin Club of the HEOA, who maintains this garden and helps keep it very beautiful for everyone to see.
An interesting fact, Toyama Kyuzo is actually buried right over there. No, not there. Actually, at Mililani Cemetery.
Behind the Issei Garden, we also have this very large rock. And this is our centennial rock. It was given to us as a gift from the Kin town. It's very heavy, and it was brought here in honor of the 100th anniversary of Okinawan immigration to Hawaii, which was in the year 2000. John, how heavy is that rock?
It's very heavy, but I think it's about 18 tons. All right, we have two of these beautiful shisas here at the Okinawan Center. They were made in Okinawa, but they were made with dirt from Okinawa, as well as dirt from right here in Waipio, to make this beautiful clay with these shisas protecting us from harm, evil, and bad karma. We were over by the male shisa, now we're here by the female shisa. And under this female shisa is a time capsule that was buried here in 1990 when the center was built, and we'll open it 50 years later, maybe earlier.
I want to welcome you to the main hall of our Hawaii Okinawa Center, which we also call the Teruya Pavilion. Thanks to the Teruya family who donated significantly to the Hawaii Okinawa, the building of the Hawaii Okinawa Center. I also want to bring note of our major donors here who helped us raise the $9 million we needed to make this dream a reality. So there are over 5,000 families, individuals, corporations from both Hawaii and Okinawa who helped donate to make this dream come true. Across the street, we also have the Hawaii Okinawa Plaza. Now, this building was opened in 2018 and has been a dream from the early 2000s to create a retail business plaza that could help sustain our Hawaii Okinawa Center. So this building has some dentists, some insurance people, there's some medical facilities, but overall, it's been a wonderful dream come true, and I want to thank the Hawaii Okinawa Plaza team for making it a reality.
What I'm holding here is one of the original Kawara tile all the way from Okinawa. 30 years ago, Okinawa donated $150,000 worth of Kawara tile to help build the Hawaii Okinawa Center. These buildings are the only buildings outside of Okinawa that have Kawara tile roofs.
I also want to welcome you to the Takakura Garden. Now, this beautiful garden here at the Hawaii Okinawa Center is one of our favorite places, and it's maintained by our volunteer gardener team. I want to thank them for all the hard work that they do to maintain this beautiful landscaping that we have here. And I want to make sure that everyone knows we have a mixture of Hawaiian and Okinawan plants here in the Takakura Garden, which makes it a real favorite place for people who are renting our facilities to do weddings, family photos, and it's just a beautiful and tranquil place.
One of the highlights of our Takakura Garden is, of course, our beautiful koi pond. So in this pond, we have over 30 koi, and they, of course, bring good luck to the Hawaii Okinawa Center. The Hawaii Okinawa Center has a lot of traditional aspects. One of that is the traditional himpun. Normally, you find this wall in front of Okinawa homes to prevent evil spirits from entering, like it helps prevent evil spirits from entering our beautiful facility. Right behind the himpun is our Higa building, which houses our museum and our administrative office.
Okay, we're here in the Higa building on the first floor, where we have a wonderful museum, and we wanted to show you some. We have some beautiful Okinawan artifacts, a lot of historical things, and a lot of things that are really important to our Hawaii Okinawa community. We're now in our Serikaku Chaya. So we also have a lot of books here that were a part of our library. And this room is really the heart and soul of what a lot of the work we do at the Hawaii Okinawa Center. So say hi, DJ.
Hey.
So once again, thank you for joining us on this very quick tour of the Hawaii Okinawa Center here in Waipio. I hope you know a little bit more about the history and cultural significance of our beautiful center here in Waipio. So mahalo and ipe nihe debiru.
Mahalo, John and Lynn. One of the most popular activities here at the center pre-COVID gave people the opportunity to learn arts and crafts.
In a recent episode of KHON's Kupuna Life, Christine Ueno introduces us to Jane Tateyama and the Monday Crafters.
Jane Tateyama felt great pride when the Hawaii Okinawa Center was built in Waipio, and she wanted to find a way to support it and honor her roots. So she began making crafts.
At the beginning, we had these paper crafting, you know, and we had all these kind of small items, you know, like what you call gift tags and, you know, whatever, and it took off.
What started out as small crafts being sold in the center's gift shop 13 years ago has grown into this. They're called the Monday Crafters, a group of about 30 volunteers. Before the pandemic, they would gather every Monday.
The best part, I think, is we potluck.
The ono food.
Yeah, yeah.
They're also busy making crafts, all from recycled materials.
So when I saw them sewing and bringing all these kinds of different items, I thought, hey, I can do some things like that.
Yeah, we're easily, you know, over close to $150,000 over the entire time that they've been together.
The Monday Crafters haven't been able to gather like they used to, but they continue to make merchandise at home and sell their items online.
It's your artwork. Art is no mistake, you know, so do what you can, do the best you can, and that's all we can you know, ask for.
We feel so proud and we feel so happy that they're enjoying it, you know. Say, oh, we made at least one person happy.
For Kupuna Life, I'm Christine Ueno, KJUN2 News.
The devoted members of the Monday Crafters hope to resume their classes when health restrictions ease.
Earlier, you got a glimpse of the beautifully landscaped Takakura and Ise Gardens here at the Hawaii Okinawa Center. There is another garden in Okinawa that helps preserve Okinawan history too. Pamela Young takes us to Shikina-en Garden in Naha City.
It's hard to believe this 10-acre Eden was completely destroyed during World War II. Once the private garden of the Sho family, the rulers of the Ryukyu Kingdom, it was used for receptions for visiting dignitaries. Restoration began in earnest in 1975. Today, it is preserved as a UNESCO World Heritage Site.
Hoping to have an in-person Okinawa festival next year. We know you are missing the fun, music, and ono grinds of past years.
The Okinawan festival has a rich history thanks to all of you who for many decades spent enjoying the day's festivities. Let's take a look back at how our festival has grown.
The Okinawan Festival is Hawaii United Okinawa Association's premier event held annually on Labor Day weekend. Organized and run by HOA, members of its 50 clubs, and over 2,000 volunteers, the celebration focuses on sharing Uchinanchu aloha. But how did this event grow for over 50,000 Hawaii residents and visitors to enjoy each year? Let's take a look back at how it all started. The first Okinawan Festival was held in 1982 at Makoi Pavilion in Ala Moana Park. By 1985, the festival had outgrown Makoi Pavilion and moved to a bigger venue, Thomas Square and the Honolulu Academy of Arts.
I think people will be very, very, invigorated by watching them. I was.
In 1990, the Okinawan Festival moved to Kapiolani Park, where the festival would grow to become one of the largest ethnic festivals in the state of Hawaii.
Aloha. Hi, Sai.
After years of celebrating the festival at Kapiolani Park, weather impacts and a change in manpower to build the festival infrastructure led the organization to move the festival to a new location. In 2018, HOA moved the Okinawan Festival to the Hawaii Convention Center, allowing our members to showcase new activities and exhibits while providing a comfortable environment for all of our attendees, from babies to senior citizens. 2020 introduced new challenges, with a global pandemic bringing the world to a halt. Determined to continue our focus of sharing our culture, we used technology to reach out well beyond our shores with our very first virtual Okinawan Festival. By gathering videos from HOA club members, our many Okinawan cultural groups, and utilizing some footage from past exciting performances, the virtual Okinawan Festival proved to be a wonderful success, a three-day virtual event with an estimated global reach of approximately 60,000. Mahalo for your support of HOA's Okinawan Festival throughout the years. Whether in person or virtual, let's continue to find ways to share Uchinanchu Aloha.
Wow, that brought back so many great memories. DJ, what do you look forward to during festival most?
You know, for me, one of my favorite activities is participating in a bon dance. I'm part of Young Okinawans of Hawaii who perform bon dances every year at the Okinawan Festival.
You know, what I look forward to is really just getting all the volunteers together in the morning. That very first parade that we do, it's really fun, you know, and we always get, you know, all these different people who come volunteer. And that starts off the performances. So for me, I always was a performer, you know, back in the day. So I really look forward to the time when we can all be backstage again.
We asked our club members what they enjoyed most.
Hey, Rod Doody! Hey, Rod Doody! Hey, Rod Doody!
Volunteering! Food, entertainment.
I like dancing at the festival. That's the best one, I think.
And the geek.
What is your favorite part of the Okinawa Festival?
Seeing old friends.
Shopping for shirts.
Performing with Senji Kai and Afusa Ryu.
Eating all the good food.
Watch my granddaughter dance.
All Okinawan Festival is about people working together and having fun. There are many traditions, and one of them is the Hairy Contest. Shibari yo!
What's your favorite part of the Okinawan Festival?
Chandida! Bondance! The Bondance!
Bondance!
Look at this!
Que linda!
Bondance!
I like Okinawan bon dance.
Food!
My favorite thing about the festival is doing bon dance.
My favorite part of the Okinawan Festival is getting to meet up with everyone and enjoy the festival together.
I love how we feature all of the Okinawan performing arts in Hawaii. And I actually get very nervous because I get to participate and perform with Afusa Ryu as well.
The food is great. The games are super fun. Dancing at the bone dance is my absolute favorite. I like to hang out with my family.
My favorite instrument is taiko.
My favorite part is that because I teach Okinawan dance for the Nakasone Dance Academy and I know how hard our students practice for the festival, it's my greatest pleasure to finally see them on stage. Families come together of many generations.
Music and dance is such an important part of our culture and we are so lucky to have a number of high caliber Okinawan performing arts schools here in Hawaii.
Okinawan dance, or Ryukyu Buyo, really showcases the beauty and vibrancy of our culture. Today, we'll share with you dancers from the Hougei Ryu Hananuzi no Kai Nakasone Dance Academy.
hello to the members of the Nakasone Dance Academy for their beautiful performance. This pandemic has been really tough for so many of our performing arts group, and music and dance are just really hard to practice while social distancing. So we truly appreciate all the hard work that all of our performing groups are doing to keep up with their arts. It is no easy task.
And mahalo to all of you who support our cultural practitioners so they can continue to thrive here in Hawaii.
There will be moments of triumph. There will be times of calm. There will be setbacks you never saw coming. Life doesn't always move in a straight line. But for over 80 years, Island Insurance has been helping people recover from the unexpected. Because the best way to keep moving forward is to get back on your feet. Island Roots, Island Values, Island Insurance.
What's your favorite Okinawan festival food? One, two, three.
Yakiniku!
The chicken plate.
Big feet too.
What is your favorite food at the Okinawan festival? Andagi.
I like the andagi the best in the festival.
The underdogs.
Andagi and Okinawa soba.
Okinawa soba.
Underdog and Okidog.
Orion beer.
Okidog. Mmm, good.
Andagi.
Andagi.
My favorite food from the Okinawa festival is the Okidog.
And mine is the Okinawan soba.
My favorite food from the Okinawa festival is yakitori chicken at the Ginoza Club booth.
Hello, my name is Blazar Kao. I'm a part of the Yone Ballroom Club. And my favorite food at the Okinawan festival is the andagi.
Hello, my name is Ryder Kao, and I am a part of the Yone Ballroom Club. My favorite food at the Okinawan festival is yakisoba.
Hi, my name is Jayla Matsuura, and I'm part of the Yone Ballroom Club. My favorite part about the Okinawan festival is the andagi.
Sata andagi and andamisu.
Of course, mine's is Okinawan soba.
Yakisoba.
Pig's feet soup, Sunday morning for breakfast.
Andagi!
Let's see. Soba, andamiso, goya, rafte. Andagi!
My favorite Okinawa festival food is the champuru plate because it has lots of vegetables.
My favorite Okinawa festival food is the champuru.
I love andadog and andagi.
My favorite food by far is the andagi. Okinawa festival makes the best andagi.
Let me ask you a question. What do karate students wear under their outfit? On the gi! On the go!
Ha! Ha! Andagi tastes really good. The Okidog is delicious.
So, hey DJ, so what's your favorite food at Okinawan Festival?
You know, my favorite food is actually rafute. Rafute is actually shoyu pork in Okinawan.
I think we put that in our champuru, yeah?
We do, yeah.
Yeah, my favorite food has to be the Okinawa soba. You know, even though it could be a hot day outside, I'd still like a really hot bowl of Okinawan soba.
So many of you enjoyed andagi and underdog and are missing them this year. But HUA President Patrick Miyashiro and Ginowan Club past president Ellen Higa have few tips on how you can make these delicious snacks at home. So put on your aprons and let's get cooking.
Thank you.
I need to mix it. Then you're gonna add the wet mix to the dry mix. And you're gonna mix it.
I think the main thing is not to overmix.
Okay, so this is the andagi batter. What we're gonna do next is we're gonna do the underdog batter. The difference between the andagi and the underdog batter is that the underdog batter is much softer. And how do we get it softer? Well, we add another cup of water. This half cup. So basically what you're doing is that you're putting these popsicle sticks into the hot dog. So all you're doing is screwing it in like this. We always have a person sitting on the table. What they're doing actually, they're sticking the hot dog in here. We coat it with potato starch, so it looks like this. And the reason why you're doing that is so that when you put it in, the batter sticks to the hot dog with the potato starch. One of the key things about cooking andagi and underdog is that the temperature. On andagi, we cook it at a lower temperature, like about 325 degrees. For underdog, we cook it at 375. It's about 50 degrees higher. Mm-hmm. And the reason why we cook it at a higher temperature is because you want a higher temperature in, because when the hot dog goes in, we want to seal the batter so it doesn't break up. You twirl it and you lift it up. When you put it in the oil, you got to make sure that it kind of seals itself. So kind of hold it a little while. Don't get your hands burned, and then you drop it in. So we're going to do about six. There's five in there now. We can do six. So basically, this batch will do about five dozen underdogs. Today, what we're trying to do is that we're trying to make andagi on a smaller basis so that you as a consumer can do it at home. The batter is such that we can use our hands. I normally like to put oil on my hands. We want to make it about a golf ball size and just drop it in. And you notice the andagi rises up after you put it in. One batch of this makes about 2 to 3 dozen of andagi, depending on the size that you make it. And you notice the andagi turns by itself, but you can help it turn. I use the skewers to make sure that they're cooked properly. Oops. Okay. What's important making andagi, making sure that you have the right temperature. Because if you have it too low, it's going to be too greasy. If you have it too high, the andagi is going to turn black. It takes about 10, 15 minutes. Get a skewer, get a thong in. Put the skewer through. If it comes out clean, that means it's cooked. Mm-hmm. Okay?
It's almost like testing for cake batter. Like, as you said, put that barbecue stick in. And when it comes out clean, it's done.
But you notice andagi has a nice flour to it, so you know the batter is good when it comes like that. We thank you for watching the andagi underdog cooking demonstration, and hopefully you got something out of it. Enjoy on our online festival. Thank you so much. Appreciate it. Mahalo.
The Hawaii United Okinawa Association's virtual Okinawan Festival is made possible thanks to donations from viewers like you. Mahalo and ippe nihe debiru.
In 1900, Okinawan immigrants arrived in Hawaii. In 1951, the United Okinawa Association was established, and 40 years later, the Okinawa Center became a reality. Through the support of over 50 individual clubs and 40,000 members, the HOA has continued its mission of promoting, preserving, and perpetuating Okinawa culture and heritage. For your support throughout these past 70 years, we express our sincerest mahalo and ipe nipe te biru.
We all have high hopes for a prosperous and healthy 2022 because a major event that happens only every 5 years will take place in Okinawa. The worldwide Uchinanchu Taikai, it's a time when Okinawans around the globe gather to reconnect with our roots and rich heritage.
Here's a look at past Taikais and a taste of what's to come.
We are Okinawa. ふるさと沖縄で5年に一度行われている世界のウチナーンチュ大会はコロナの影響で延期になりました。とても残念です。私たちウチナーンチュにはこれまでいくつもの困難を支え合って乗り越えてきた歴史があります。 世界のうちなんちのみんなに会いたい。その思いを大切に、ふるさと沖縄からエールを送ります。
大和町でコロナに負けるな。綺麗な海、綺麗な空と一緒に待ってるよ。うちなんちの心は一つ。
わしだよ、うちなんちの心を。
みんなを待っちゃんだ。
うちなんちの笑顔でコロナを吹き飛ばせ。
うちなんちの皆さん、沖縄で待ってます。
つながりを忘れない、いつまでも。
皆さんが沖縄に来るのを待っちょいみん
な。私たちは
みんなを待っています。
私たちは同じうちなんち、
うちなんちの仲間に
会いたい。
みんなのことを
知りたい。一緒に
遊びたい。
2021年に
叶わなかった思いを
2022年につなげます。
沖縄で
会える日を
楽しみにしています。
2022年、最高の笑顔で会えることを楽しみにしています。マッチョンド。
また会える日を。
It is always amazing to see how many countries and U.S. states are represented.And to know we all have one common bond.
The opening ceremonies, the grand parade, the closing concert, and more.
People come from different countries, we speak different languages, but yet we share common values, a common heritage.
Attending the opening and closing ceremonies, and last but not least, shopping for more Kari Yushi shirts.
Just being in Okinawa, eating Okinawan soba,Visiting family and buying Kari Yushi wear.
Mimi Tani wa Jakimi Joshi mo ari, Akai Inku mo, Ohaka mo ari, Jampa Misaki mo arimasu. Sore ga ichiban suki desu.
Getting back to my heritage, seeing a lot of people shorter and hairier than me, but most of all, drinking Orion! Kari!
The Orion Beer Factory.
I'm looking forward to seeing the Asa Festival.And being able to see Begin and hopefully the opening or closing ceremonies.
I look forward to meeting like new people.
The parade.
And meeting up with family and friends.
Snippets of this year's Okinawan Festival and that you learned a little bit more about Okinawa too.
Each year, whether in person or virtual, we rely on you and appreciate your donation and support to help the Hawaii United Okinawan Association continue to perpetuate the Okinawan culture here in Hawaii. Thanks to all of you, together we thrive. Chimegoku de Tichi, all hearts unite as one.
In closing, as with any Okinawan event, some of our members want to show their thanks.With some final kachashi music.
Mahalo and ippe nippe de bitan.
Yeah.
The Okinawan Festival is proudly presented by the Hawaii United Okinawa Association, Central Pacific Bank Foundation, and these fine sponsors.
Why should I pay for channels I don't watch?
My Way TV is back for a limited time. Get the starter pack with more than 85 must-watch channels. Then you choose what to add.
I want movies.
Family channels.
What's up?
Cartoons. Don't judge.
Plus, you can bundle My Way TV with Hawaii's fastest internet, only from Hawaiian Telcom. Get My Way TV and 500 meg fiber internet now for this great price. Discover the power of fiber.
My Way.
My Way.
My Way.
I'm Dan Abrams. I'm a news analyst, author, and most importantly, a dad.